a good week so far and that you're doing well. I wanted to share a couple of things that I have been reading about in my devotional time, and it focuses on the terms of joy and happiness. If you think about happiness, a lot of times it's described as something that's external. A lot of times it's described as something that is materialistic. Whereas joy, many times, is described as something that is within ourselves, something that has a moral attribute, or is something that is more consistent and long-lasting. I know in your household, probably as well as mine, I've heard from many of you that things that bring us happiness or things that we are excited about have been changed or have been canceled. And that has been the case in our house too, especially with my kids. You know, they haven't been in school, they haven't been able to play sports and do different things during the summer that they like to do normally. And that has caused some sadness, of course, but it's just part of what we're having to deal with right now. And I think the biggest source of encouragement that I have had in recent months is when we had to sit down and tell our kids something that we actually knew they were not going to be very happy about. Every year we go on a vacation with my family, my mom and dad, my brother and his family, my sister and her family. We all go up to Lake Michigan and we have a beach house and we go to batting cages and we play on the beach. And it's just a lot of fun, and it's just something that my kids look forward to every single year. And unfortunately, just because of various things going on, we just haven't been able to do that. And so we're having to cancel it and do it again, hopefully next summer. But we had to all sit down, and I was kind of dreading it because I knew that my kids were going to be very sad that they weren't able to go. And of course they weren't. There was some sadness there. The happiness and the excitement that they feel about that vacation was now kind of gone. And I didn't know if it would actually really help, but we sat down and we said, okay, we know that you are very sad about not being able to go on this vacation, but we're gonna go to Grandma and Grandpa's house and we're gonna be able to see our family. I know it's not the beach house, but we're still gonna go. And I was so encouraged that the sadness that they had been feeling and the happiness that they normally have about going to the beach house was replaced by joy. They were so excited. The beach house and the batting cages and all the stuff that we do on that vacation just kind of fell by the side. And it was because they are truly joyful that they are going to be able to see their family for the first time in actually 7 months. It's been quite a while. And so they are so excited, and I was so encouraged by that, and it reminded me of some verses that talk about joy. There are actually a lot, but I just wanted to share a couple with you. Psalm 16:11 says, "You have made known to me the path of life. You fill me with joy in your presence." John 15:11 says, "I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that the joy may be complete." It was just so refreshing to watch my kids, and it was a good reminder to me, and the Lord just saying, "Missy, the things of this world are very different right now, and a lot of things that make us happy are just simply not happening, or they've been taken away from us." But I felt like he was saying, "But my joy is made complete in you." And so I don't know what kind of week you've had, what kind of summer you've had. I know it's been kind of crazy for all of us. But my hope and my prayer is that regardless of the things that make us happy or the things that we get excited about, that our true joy is found in Christ. I loved what somebody said. It says, "The joy in Christ does not compare to the temporary happiness of this world." Let's pray together. Jesus, thank you for reminding me that even if our happiness is taken away, our joy is still complete in you. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for helping us through difficult times. And thank you that no matter what is going on around us, that you love us, that we matter, that you still fill us with joy. Please help us to be people that show your joy to others. Be with us this week as we finish. Help us to further your kingdom and to be exactly who we need to be for others. Thank you, God, for all that you have done.